Yo, what is up, guys? It is Bumfris, back with episode 99 of our Reddit series. This one's going to be a little bit more Entitled Parents, and I know you're going to love this one. So close to episode 100, it's literally just around the corner. I guarantee it will be sometime this week, and you guys will love it. So do me a favor, leave a like on this video real quick. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe, then sit back, relax, and get annoyed at some Entitled Parents. Now, one thing you need to understand is how my mother can get. Just a quick short story, I was once in a test at uni. My phone was required to be turned off for the 2 hours that I was there. I came back, turned my phone on, and instantly got missed calls and messages from her. Every single message consisted of, "When I call you, you pick up." She insisted that I sneak my phone into the test with me so that if she calls, I can leave an answer. I'd automatically fail my test for this, and I'm registered as a student with disability, so I get double time on my tests. As a result, during my tests, I can't have any contact outside the center. I can take a break if I need, but I have to spend it in the lobby. To this day, she still thinks that I was in the wrong for having my phone off. And now that you've met my mother, on with the story. I'm a university student. I live on campus for most of the year and only live with my parents on breaks. Anyone familiar with the school year knows that election day does not land anywhere near any breaks. In my state, you can have your voter registration address as your on-campus address if you live on campus. They actually encourage it since you spend most of your year there and therefore your elections actually directly affect you. So, I did. I changed my address on my registration to my dorm room address. Needless to say, there was a local election back home and my family was keen on us all participating and voting for a particular person. My mum, about a week before the election, called and asked me to apply for an absentee vote for the local election back home. I told her that I had changed my address to the one on campus. She replied offended with, "Why? You don't live there." The logic, however, is simple. I spend 9 months living in my dorm, half a state away from home. I spend 1 month home for winter break and 2 months home for summer break. Essentially, you do live where you go to school, and the state sees it that way too. You pay rent, you pay electricity, water, you sleep there, you live there. Now, the deadline to apply for absentee voting had already passed by the time she had called. When I pointed that out, she again took it personally. She wanted me to just get one anyway. When I told her that I couldn't, she then asked me to instead change my address back. Now, the deadline in my state to change your address before an election is around a month. She called me a week before. Even after being told that it would be illegal for me to try and vote at home, especially since I'm voting in the local elections in the campus area, which again, she took very offensively, she tried to tell me to just do it anyway because she already told her friends that I was voting there. An hour into the argument, I finally revealed that even if it was possible for me to switch back addresses in time, even if I could still apply for absentee, that I would not, as then I can't vote in the elections local to the campus, and that was where I was voting. I was voting for the area around my campus because, as I spend most of my year there and will be for a long time, the policies affect me more than the policies of a location that I spend barely any time at. I also like the area around my campus so much that, like many previous students, I decided to move there after I graduate. This she was okay with. This she understood. But she couldn't understand why I would vote there instead of home. The last thing she said to me for election day was, "Okay, just remember how to apply for absentee. Who knows, you might get it. Even if you don't, I'll just pick you up if you drive down here so you can vote." She didn't say this in a mean way, but as a cheery, "I'm trying to help" way, and I honestly believe that she was trying to help me. But she refused to listen to me when I told her how illegal what she was suggesting was. After the election, she mentioned that she would just tell everyone that I voted there anyway, and that I voted for the specific person that they were rooting for. I didn't care. She can do what she wants, but I made it clear that if I was personally asked, I would tell them that it would be impossible as I'm registered to vote in a different county. She's mostly dropped it by now, but she still acts really offended if it's ever brought up that I wouldn't break the law for her. I'm ready to put up with it again this year. It's really no big deal, just a little argument, though I suppose I should point out that some friends caught glimpses of my messages with her, as she was messaging me constantly, which prompted me to bring it up during a counseling session, and the counselor on the spot labeled the relationship toxic. I am an adult though, and it's a nuisance at this point, if anything. In case it isn't clear, she didn't do anything illegal, as she never actually tried to apply for my absentee. I know this because if I had even applied, I would have gotten a confirmation mail at my registered address at my campus, and I never got it. However, it's at the point where I wouldn't even waste a second to notify police of an attempted voter fraud if she did. And I made it very clear that I didn't vote at home, so whenever somebody brings up how my mother told them I did, I make it clear that I did not, and they suddenly get very untrusting of her, which she thinks is somehow my fault. oh well, it's a shame that I don't care. Man, what kind of world do we live in where voter fraud is frowned upon? Like, this should be something that I can't even say it. It just sounds so stupid. Like, this clearly is one of the more entitled parents that we've ever come across in this series. And honestly, there's really just not much to say. I was waiting in line behind a woman in her mid-30s pushing a double pram and a large shopping cart, which was overflowing. After the groceries were scanned and packed, she tried to pay with two cards, which both declined. She made the cashier try the first card twice, and she said, "Sorry, this is a new card." This turned out to be a lie, as her second card also declined, but with no excuse this time. She didn't have a single bill in her wallet. This is where the entitlement starts. Once she realized that she has no way of paying, she starts saying, "I'm so sorry, I'll pay for it next time. Print the bill up and I'll pay for it next time I'm in the store." This is Stop and Shop, right? A chain supermarket. Lol. The poor attendant is trying to tell her that they don't let people take groceries and pay later, so she starts to become aggravated and starts taking it personally, saying, "You are trying to make my family starve this week." She then starts pushing the pram and the massive cart out past the register at the same time, jerking them both back and forth as she has one arm on either. Needless to say, the manager and a fellow customer stop her at the door and advise her to leave before they call the police. She then puts two hands on the cart, leaving the pram, and attempted to push it past the two people in her way. With the manager and the member of the public stood in front of her shopping cart, she realized that she wasn't going to get away with it this time. She then snuffed her nose upwardly and starts violently jerking the pram to turn it around and screams into the manager's face that she is going to Shaw's next time. Needless to say, the manager was like, "Thank goodness." The kids were in tears the whole time, so you can imagine what a scene this was. I hate to say it, but this is one of those really sad entitlement stories because she's probably not, I mean, look, she's obviously in the wrong, but she's not probably doing this for the entirely wrong reasons. I mean, at the end of the day, she does have a family to feed. I just don't think she realizes that the way she went about it probably wasn't the best way to go about it at all. Like I said, she's absolutely in the wrong, but it is hard for me not to just have a little bit of sympathy because honestly, she did just need to feed her kids and she was probably in a really tough situation. But at the end of the day, you got to go about it the right way. So my family is getting ready to move. Most of our stuff is packed up in the garage. My drums are out there too, but unpacked and set up because I play in a hardcore band and we do practice there. There's this really cute kid, let's call him CK, who always knocks on the garage door and asks to try out the drums. Sometimes I let him. I really like the little guy. His mother, the entitled mum however, is a big piece of work. On this particular day, I was studying for a midterm in my room when I hear someone on my drums. I thought it was my sibling, who I don't trust around the kits anymore, because they punched holes in two of the tom heads, so I went out to tell them to get off it. However, it seemed that they were out in the neighborhood and left the garage door open. On the kit was CK, and entitled mum was in the driveway recording him. I walked outside and asked them who they had asked to use the kit, and the entitled mum said that the garage door was open and that CK wanted to play. I was a bit shocked that she just let him walk up and play, especially because it was technically inside our house. I started to explain that I was fine with him playing as long as he asked, but she started to say that she was supervising him so they didn't have to. I was annoyed by this, but I decided not to comment on it. I told the entitled mum that I needed them to leave because I was studying and I needed to close the garage door. She was not happy about this, and she started to go on about how CK just wanted to play the drums and that I was preventing him from learning. I said that I was sorry, but I couldn't have them there at this time. CK seemed fine with it, probably because he knew that I'd let him play some other time, but the entitled mum started yelling at him to sit back down and keep playing. I kept telling her that I needed to study, but she wasn't having a bar of it. I really didn't want to threaten to call the cops on her, but she started to become hostile towards me, yelling and telling me what a horrible person I was. CK seemed pretty embarrassed about the whole thing. When I told the entitled mum that I would call the police if she didn't leave, she walked up to the drum set and tried to pick it up and move it. Unfortunately for her, I used frame mounts for my cymbals and the bass drum was in between the frame posts. She wasn't going anywhere with my drums. When she started unscrewing my cymbals, I called the cops. The entitled mum was out of there extremely fast once I was on the phone. I ended up directing the cops to her house when they showed up, and now, whenever she sees me, I get a dirty stare and some rude language. CK still comes over every once in a while, and I like to teach him wherever I can. He is still a really cute kid. I feel like I end up saying this a lot, but this kid, and probably a lot of other kids when it comes to entitled parents, I really do feel sorry for. From like day one, the moment they are born, or let's say second one, they are already at a disadvantage in life because they have a parent who, quite frankly, is probably not going to give them the best example of what it's like to be a person. They think that everything belongs to them. They have no ability to value the things that they have because whatever else they want, they'll just take it. On the flip side of the coin, it must be nice just being able to get whatever you want whenever you want to get it. Okay, so when I was 7, me and my mum went shopping to Asda. It was just me and my mum, since my dad had been working late a lot lately, so I was pretty happy. I think it was like a Thursday at like maybe 9 o'clock, since that was when the reduced items would be at their cheapest. All I know is that it was dark and there wasn't a ton of people in the store. While we were shopping, my mum started flirting with some guy, so obviously I quickly became bored and just started reorganizing the vegetables. Somebody had placed a cauliflower and a bag of carrots amongst the broccoli, and I was a little bit OCD, so I was not letting that go. By the time I turned back around after maybe like 2 or 3 minutes, my mum was gone. I didn't panic because my mum did this a lot, so I just headed to the alcohol aisles, figuring that she'd be there. She wasn't there, so I started panicking a little. I searched the entire store and she wasn't there. I didn't want to go to the front desk because I didn't really trust adults, plus I was still terrified of somebody figuring out that my parents weren't the best and getting put into foster care. When I went back outside, there were only like maybe 5 or 6 cars left in the car park. I didn't know my mum's license plate number, but my mum's car was a bright turquoise Corsa, so it was very noticeably absent. It was dark and it had started spitting lightly, but I didn't want to go back inside because again, you can't trust strangers. I was fairly mature for my age and I knew the way home. The streetlights were pretty bright and it was only just over 2 miles home up the main road. So I started walking. It was kind of cold and I was pretty wet by the time I got home. Also, my legs hurt quite a bit since I was pretty small back then. When I walked back inside, my mum was on the sofa, joint in hand, completely unconcerned. I stopped and stared at her and she said something along the lines of, "Took you long enough." It snapped me out of my stunned silence, so I quickly asked her why she hadn't looked for me. She then just said something along the lines of, "I did look for you, but I couldn't find you, so I left." I didn't know what to say since my mum would probably smack me if I raised my voice, so I just walked to my room and changed into some dry clothes. I never challenged my mum because I was just a quiet little kid and took honor thy mother and thy father way too seriously. I hate that in the last story I literally just talked about having horrible parents and how that impacts the kids, and then I come across a story like this where you can tell that this has probably had a massive impact on this kid for their entire life. Like I said before though, it literally makes me sad knowing that there are kids on the end of these parents, and like, obviously, right, they wouldn't be entitled parents unless they had kids, but there are kids on the end of these parents and they have to suffer with that every single day. We only see like the tip of the iceberg when it comes to entitled parents. These kids deal with them every single day and we just see like the smallest amount possible. Honestly, we should all just be so grateful that we didn't grow up with entitled parents. Alright everyone, that is that for today's episode of Entitled Parents. I just want to start off by saying thank you so much for watching and I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm just going to take a second to plug a couple of my social medias, including our Discord server. I do have a Twitter and an Instagram if you want to follow me on both of those. They are both at Bumfris, and feel free to send me a message and I'll do my best to respond. I also just want to take a second to say thank you so much for all the love lately. All of the comments, the likes, the subscribers, just the fact that you guys tune in and watch my videos every day, it really does make my day. Every single one of you is the backbone of this channel and I really cannot express how much I appreciate that. Without you guys, this channel would be nothing and I love making these videos for you guys and I love the fact that you enjoy them. So on that note, I will wrap things up for today's episode of Entitled Parents. I just want to take a second again to say thank you so much for watching. I hope you're all having a fantastic day, and I'll see you all in the next episode of Entitled Parents. Bye.